Aykroyd and Jim Belushi's Big Man Music. And ooh, Midnight Confessions. Your local news is next.
President Bush says he's willing to meet with Middle East leaders if there would be a chance for advancing the peace process. That story and more coming up next on NewsCenter 1.
You're watching the award-winning NewsCenter 1 at 10.
Good evening, I'm Elizabeth Hopkins.
And I'm Al Van Zee. Thank you for choosing NewsCenter 1.
The Rapid City Council held a special meeting this afternoon to again discuss appropriating funds for the proposed public safety building project. By a vote of 8-3, the council decided to appropriate the needed $900,000 for the public safety building. However, there are some stipulations from the council. The contractor will not start remodeling of the jail until notice to proceed has been given by the council and the county commissioners. The council will also review all change orders in excess of $10,000.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 at 10 with Al Van Zee, Elizabeth Hopkins, Chief Meteorologist Bob Riggio, and Ryan Gunn Sports. You're watching NewsCenter 1.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Justin Wickersham, filling in for Brittany Scheck. Thank you for joining us for NewsCenter 1 today. Coming up in this half hour, Wells Fargo says it's laying off 3,800 employees over the next year.
You're watching NewsCenter 1.
Minimum wage workers are about to get a raise, but is that really a good thing? And the fate of smokers is still uncertain in South Dakota. Why the ban won't go to a vote, at least for now. Good evening, I'm Krista Fogelsong. Michael Dupre has the night off. Thousands of signatures were counted and verified, but the chance for voters to head to the polls to vote on a statewide smoking ban has been snuffed out. South Dakota Secretary of State Chris Nelson has rejected petitions calling for a statewide vote on the smoking ban because not enough valid signatures were submitted. He says the effort to challenge the law fell 221 signatures short out of more than 25,000 submitted. Nelson says the Attorney General is researching when the law will take effect, but either side can still appeal the decision to a judge and eventually to the state Supreme Court. This year, the legislature passed a law expanding the smoking ban so it would outlaw smoking in bars and casinos. Opponents submitted petitions to put the issue on the ballot of next year, but supporters challenged nearly 10,000 of those petition signatures as being invalid. Well, a lot of South Dakotans stand to get a pay raise on Friday when the state's minimum wage is scheduled to increase another 70 cents to $7.25 an hour. If you've been waiting for an alternative to LASIK, a new option is finally in the Black Hills. We'll have the details after the forecast.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 at 5:30 with Krista Fogelsong, Michael Dupre, Chief Meteorologist Bob Riggio, and Justin Wickersham with sports.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 today with Jessica Nappi, meteorologist Eric Brooke, meteorologist Louis Gore, and Anya Mueller.
This is NewsCenter 1 with Hannah Zook, Shad Olson, sports with Justin Wickersham, and weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Riggio.
Coming up on NewsCenter 1 today, candidates will take advantage of the week between Christmas and New Year's to meet as many voters as possible. NBC News correspondent Edward Lawrence looks at the latest. Then, arcade games like Donkey Kong and Pac-Man are making a comeback here in Rapid City. Find out where you can feel like a kid again. Monica Davis has the details this morning. And some children are seeing a brighter picture for the future, learning how to visualize their dreams. The gift of cameras. NBC's Miguel Amiger reports. Wednesday, December 30th, 2015.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 today with Anya Mueller, meteorologist Louis George, and Monica Davis.
And good Wednesday morning, everyone. A live look there of our beautiful town of Rapid City. I'm Anya Mueller.
And I'm Louis George, and it is a chilly start to that Wednesday morning. It's a pretty start. I love the snow. I love the lights.
it always gives such a nice, just such a nice kind of like glow. Yeah. Ambiance, can you say ambiance?
Picturesque.
Picturesque, thank you.
Lots of $10 words this morning.
Yeah, I know.
Ambiance, picturesque.
I know, but I don't think I used the word ambiance right. I think picturesque was the better word for that.
Whatever.
Yeah, but whatever. But it is Wednesday, so that means that it is also a Wellness Wednesday.
Yes.
Which I'm excited about because that means it's another edition of Healthy Cooking with Anya.
In the kitchen with Anya Mueller.
I'm pretty pumped
That's
about
me.
That.
Okay.
You know I've tried your stuff, right? Like, I don't just watch it and like throw it away. Like, I try
you do?
The wraps. I've tried the wraps.
Oh, you have?
They're very
you
good.
You never told me that.
They're very good. Yeah, so I don't just like act like I like them. I really do like them. They're good.
Okay, well, I'm glad you're not just, you know, acting for me.
Yeah, no, I would never do that. What you get with me is full sense.
Face value.
Face value.
Louis George, right here.
Exactly. I'm okay. Sincere in everything
yes.
that I say.
Actually, and Nicole Craig will be in from the YMCA to talk about New Year's resolutions and how
man.
To keep them. Silverado Franklin Hotel, Wednesday, December 30th, 2015.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 Today with Anya Mueller, meteorologist Louis George, and Monica Davis.
And good Wednesday morning, everyone. A live look there in Rapid City as we come back. Thanks for joining us for the second half of NewsCenter 1 Today.
I'm Louis George, and it is a nice, it's a little breezy out there, but overall it's a chilly morning. But like I've been saying, you know, with this winter weather, I don't mind it as much because it, like the scenery, especially
winter?
Around here, the Black Hills, well, it's winter.
Your one news source. This is NewsCenter 1.
Good evening, I'm Chad Olson. This is NewsCenter 1 at 5:30. Local law enforcement making an arrest in connection with a burglary of a charity last weekend. We'll find out just how Santa's reindeer are going to be faring and how many footprints they'll be leaving coming up in just 4 days' time. Bob's forecast for this Christmas week on the way in just a bit. And we're back with more news after the break right here on NewsCenter 1.
This is NewsCenter 1 with Chad Olson. Sports with Justin Wickersham. And weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Riggio. Your one news source. This is NewsCenter 1.
Good evening, I'm Chad Olson. This is NewsCenter 1 at 10. Terrorist attacks can happen anywhere, anytime. That's why South Dakota's Homeland Security Office is encouraging citizens to watch for signs that could indicate possible terrorist activity.
I really don't think that's going to amount to much, but don't be surprised if you see a few little snowflakes falling from the sky.
They were kind of out there floating
yeah.
as I was on my way in.
Yeah.
We'll get more details with Bob in just a bit in his full forecast. We're back with more news after the break, right here on NewsCenter 1 at 10.
This is NewsCenter 1 with Chad Olson. Sports with Justin Wickersham. And weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Riggio.
You're watching NewsCenter 1 Today.
Coming up on NewsCenter 1 Today, last night the Rapid City Common Council took a first step toward emergency action against the coronavirus. We've got the latest on that story still ahead. Then a traffic heads up. Travel will be restricted on several roads in Rapid City starting today. We've got the
You're watching NewsCenter 1 Today.
Coming up on NewsCenter 1 Today, we've learned some more information about the report of a man with a gun outside of Rushmore Mall on Sunday afternoon. We're coming up on this Tuesday, October 22nd, 2019.
NewsCenter 1 Today with Samantha Chadwell and Brant Beckman.
Morning. Here's a live look from downtown Rapid City. What a nice, I don't want to jinx it, but I want to say calm morning.
Well, you are foreshadowing something there, and I appreciate
You're watching NewsCenter 1 Today.
Good morning, I'm Samantha Chadwell. Welcome to NewsCenter 1 Early Edition. We're learning more information this morning about what happened Sunday afternoon at the Rushmore Mall that led to people evacuating the area and one man being taken into custody.
This is NewsCenter 1.
Good evening and thanks for joining us for NewsCenter 1 at 5:30. I'm Anya Mueller. Here in South Dakota, flu season officially begins in December.
This is NewsCenter 1 at 6.
Tuesday night, that small plane that crashed near Aberdeen about 2 weeks ago has now been found along with the body of the pilot. The Brown County Sheriff's Office says a hunter found the wreckage last night 3 miles north of Aberdeen.
This is NewsCenter 1.
Thursday night, 24 hours from now, the red, white, and boom over Mount Rushmore will have come to an end. The President of the United States is going to start making his way back to Washington, and 7,500 people lucky enough to get tickets will be making their way home or elsewhere to continue their celebration.
This is NewsCenter 1.
It is always fire season in the Black Hills, especially when it's this dry and this windy. Two fires igniting this afternoon. We have much more ahead for you tonight. Murder at an assisted living center in the Rockies, why police say a resident did it. And Republicans on Capitol Hill getting ready to decide whether to strip committee assignments from one of their own.
NewsCenter 1.
Good evening and thanks for joining us for NewsCenter 1. I'm Colton Hall. Now, if you were up at Terry Peak today, chances are you probably saw something different on the slopes. The pond skim combines creativity, skills, and even just a little bit of luck for the skiers and snowboarders who are trying their best to glide across some 30 feet of water after coming down the mountain at full speed.
This is NewsCenter 1. This is NewsCenter 1 at 10.
Monday night, and we begin with a question. What do you get when you combine sanctions against Russia and supply chain issues? The answer is rising costs for South Dakota farmers. Nitrogen fertilizer is not only getting more difficult to find, but it is a lot more expensive. A lot more expensive when you do find it. NewsCenter 1's Darsha Nelson on why all of us need to pay attention to this.
Yeah.
Connect Center 1. We just connect.